Hi students, today we are going to see about the extraction of copper. So copper is found in native state and as well as in the combined state. That means copper which may be found in the earth crust as a free form, that is called as native state, and also in the combined form. Combined form means copper can mix with oxygen or sulfur to form as a compound. So the symbol of copper is Cu and atomic number is 29. Now the important ores of copper are copper pyrite, cuprite and copper glands. Copper pyrite, the formula is CuFeS2. Cuprite, the formula is Cu2O, and copper glands is Cu2S. In all the three ores, copper is present as a sulfide, as an oxide and also Cu2S. So when we compare these three ores, the copper is found in enormous amount in the copper pyrite ore. Hence the chief ore of copper is copper pyrite. It yields nearly 76% of the world production of copper. That means of total world production of copper, our India produces 76% of copper. Then the extraction of copper from copper pyrite involves the following steps. The first step for the concentration of the ore, that means we have to remove the copper from the copper pyrite, that is from the earth crust. It involves five steps. The first step is the concentration of ore. The ore is crushed, and the crushed means it makes them into fine powder and the concentrated by froth flotation process. Froth flotation means because it is a sulfide ore, the sulfide substance does not soluble with water. So we have to mix with pine oil, and the sulfide ore can mix with the pine oil and form as a foam, and the impurities will dissolve with the water and settle at the bottom. So this is the way we have to concentrate the ore. So concentration of the ore, since it is a sulfide ore, we can concentrate only by froth flotation process. The next, roasting. Roasting means at high temperature, with the help of excess air, we are heating the ore. So the concentrated ore is roasted in excess of air. This line is very, very important. So the concentrated ore is roasted in presence of excess air. During this process, suppose if any impurities and also any moisture is present, it can easily be removed. That means in copper pyrite ore, if any impurities like sulfur, phosphorus, arsenic, and antimony, if it is present, means it can combine with excess oxygen and it removed as oxides. Copper pyrite is partly converted into sulfides of copper and iron. Now the copper pyrite is oxidized to copper sulfide and iron sulfate and sulfur dioxide. Now the metal which is converted as a sulfide ore, it is splitted into Cu2S and FeS, but we need only Cu2S. So it undergoes a smelting process. The roasted ore now is mixed with powdered coke and sand. Powdered coke means is nothing but carbon, and sand, it is heated in a blast furnace. Blast furnace means with the excess of air to obtain mate. Mate means it is a mixture of Cu2S plus FeS and slag. The slag means the waste impurities. The slag is removed as a waste. So first step is the concentration of the ore. Second step is the roasting process, that is heating. Third step, the sulfide ore can be converted into oxide ore. Now the roasted ore is mixed with the powdered coke and sand and is heated in a blast furnace. Now it changes into mate. Mate is nothing but it is a mixture of Cu2S and FeS. The slag is removed as a waste material. Slag means the waste particles, that is the iron can combine with the sand. Sand formula is SiO2, so it remove as FeSiO3. The slag is removed as a waste. Next step is besimerization process. The molten mate, which is transformed to the Bessemer converter. That means converter means it is a vessel in which the besimerization process takes place. So the molten mate means the liquid state of mate, which is transformed to the Bessemer converter in order to obtain blister copper. Blister copper means 98% pure metal and 2% is impurities. So ferrous sulfide, which is obtained from, is oxidized to ferrous oxide, and which is reacting with silica, that is sand, to form as a FeSiO3 as a slag. Slag means as a waste material, because we need only copper, no need for collecting the iron. That's why that FeS is oxidized to form FeO and sulfur dioxide. That FeO is reacting with silica to form FeSiO3 as a slag. Now the required material, that is Cu2S, now oxidized to form cuprous oxide, that is Cu2O and SO2. That Cu2O again combined with a little Cu2S to form the blistered copper. So equations is very, very important. The question may ask the separate question, write the besimerization process of copper. So in this besimerization, the matte, which is split up to Cu2S and FeS, that FeS is coming as a slag, that is FeSiO3. Cu2S is now changes into blister copper. Blister copper means 98% pure copper and 2% impurities. Now the 98% pure copper is now you have to change them into 100% pure copper by the electro refining process. Next step is refining process, that is electro refining process of copper. So refining means that is 100% pure copper, we have to convert them. Now the blister copper contains 98% pure copper and 2% impurities, which is purified by the electrolytic refining. Electrolytic refining means we have to pass the electricity to the molten solution of copper sulfate and sulfuric acid in a large tank, and we have to insert as a impure copper as an anode and pure copper as a cathode. Now passing the electricity, the copper which is from the impure side, which is deposited on the pure cathode side, and the impurities are settled at the bottom. So which is settled at the anode side, that's why it is called as an anode mud. So electrolytic refining means by passing the electricity, we have to purify the impure copper to a 100% pure metal. So this method is used to get metal a high degree of purity. For electrolytic refining of copper, we have to need one cathode, anode and the electrolyte. Cathode means a thin plate of pure copper metal we have to take. Anode, in anode side, we have to take a block of impure copper. So cathode, pure copper, anode, impure copper metal. Then electrolyte means a copper sulfate solution which is acidified, that is mixed with a dilute sulfuric acid. When current is passing through the electrolyte solution, pure copper gets deposited at the cathode and the impurities are deposited at the anode, and they are called as an anode mud. So in this way we have to extract the copper. So the various process are, first one is concentration, second one is roasting, third one smelting process, and the fourth one is besimerization, and the final step is the electrolytic refining. By using these all steps, we can extract or we can convert the 100% pure copper metal from the copper pyrite ore. So in this topic, electrolytic refining question is a separate one, and besimerization question is a separate one, and the important two more question is what are the ores of copper. So as a full question means write the extraction of copper from copper pyrite ore is a detailed question. We have to start from ore up to electrolytic refining. Next topic is the physical properties of copper. So in this area, one more question will come. So copper is a reddish brown metal. So the color of copper is reddish brown with a high luster. Luster means a shining property, and having copper is having high density and high melting point, that is 1356 degree Celsius. So because that's why it is used in the electrical cable wire. Now I am going to explain about the chemical properties of copper. So first, chemical properties, I will explain the more important one. First one is the important one, action of air and moisture. So copper gets covered with a green layer of basic copper carbonate in the presence of carbon dioxide and moisture. That means when copper, that is Cu, when it is reacting with the atmospheric air, that is O2, and carbon dioxide and moisture. So all the three, O2, CO2 and water, all these reacting with the copper to form a green substance called as copper carbonate and copper hydroxide. Its formula is CuCO3.CuOH twice. Its color is green color. The next, action of heat. This is very important question. What happened when copper is heated below 1370 and above 1370 Kelvin? So on heating at different temperatures, that is below 1370 Kelvin, when copper is heated, that is roasted in presence of oxygen, it forms copper oxide. That is, its formula is CuO, copper 2 oxide, and the color is black color. Next, when copper is treated with above 1370 Kelvin, it forms a red cuprous oxide. So first one, that is CuO is cupric, and Cu2O means cuprous oxide, its color is red. So at two different temperatures, copper can reacting with oxygen to form a different oxides, that is black cupric and red cuprous oxides. The next, action with dilute acids. So dilute acids means, when this is not more important, but just I am explaining it. Dilute acids such as HCl, H2SO4 have no action on these metals. But when it is reacting in the presence of excess air, it forms copper chloride and water. Then with nitric acid also, copper reacts with the dilute HNO3 with the liberation of nitric oxide, and with the H2SO4, it forms copper sulfate and oxygen. So the reactions of third, that is actions of acid, not very much important. First two chemical properties is very important, that is action of air and moisture, and number two is action of heat. Properties, action of chlorine. Chlorine reacts with the copper, resulting in the formation of a copper 2 chloride. Just copper, when reacting with the chlorine, chlorine symbol is Cl2, it forms copper chloride. The next one is important, one more question. Copper is not attacked by alkali. Alkali means sodium hydroxide, potassium hydroxide, copper hydroxide, like that. So with the alkalis or hydroxides or with any bases, copper is not attacked. Only with the dilute acids, it can react, but not with the alkalis. The next final one is uses of copper. We know already copper is used in many way in our day-to-day life for making vessels, for making electrical cable, these and all we know. But here in your textbook it is given us, it is extensively used in manufacturing electrical cable and other electrical appliances. Electrical cable means electrical cable wire, that is. Second point, for making utensils, that is vessels, containers, and calorimeters and coins. Calorimeters means in physics lab you are going to use that calorimeter for measuring the specific heat capacity of any liquid. So that is, that vessel we call it as a calorimeter. Calorie, that means energy, that is how much amount of heat energy. And we know coin for making gold coin or copper coin, copper is used. Then third point, it is used in electroplating for any very cheap metals, like we are going to give any coating such as copper, means that is with the help of electric current, we call it as a electroplating. Then fourth one, important one, we know already, it is alloyed with the gold and the silver for making coins and jewels. So these are the uses of copper. So far children, we saw the extraction of copper, all the starting from ore up to refining process, physical property, chemical properties and its uses. Thank you children.